Welcome to e-learning course on Applied Thermodynamics, Module Reciprocating Compressor, Session Introduction to Reciprocating Compressor and Single Stage Reciprocating Compressors. Myself Ramesh Beer, Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Jain Institute of Technology, Davanagere. There are various methods to compress air. The simplest one is by means of a piston cylinder arrangement. Atmospheric air is drawn into the cylinder and the piston, having reciprocating motion, moves forward in the cylinder. It compresses the air into a smaller space, thus rising its pressure. The high pressure air from the cylinder is delivered to a storage vessel or receiver, from where it can be supplied for a specific applications. Compressors are work absorbing devices which are used for increasing pressure of fluid at the expense of work done on fluid. The compressors used for compressing air are called air compressors. Compressors are invariably used for all applications requiring high pressure air. Some of popular applications of compressors are for driving pneumatic tools and air operated equipment, spray painting, compressed air engine, supercharging, surface cleaning, refrigeration and air conditioning, chemical industry, etc. Compressors are supplied with low pressure air at inlet, which comes out as high pressure air at outlet. Work required for increasing pressure of air is available from the prime mover driving the compressor. Generally, electric motor, internal combustion engine or steam engine, turbine, etc. are used as prime movers. Compressors are similar to fans and blowers but differ in terms of pressure ratios. Fans is said to have pressure ratio up to 1.1 and blowers have pressure ratio between 1.1 to 4, and while for compressors pressure ratio will be more than 4. Moving on to next one, classifications of compressor. Compressors can be classified in the following different ways. Based on principal operation, compressors are classified as positive displacement and dynamic compressors. Positive displacement compressors are the compressors where the compression is realized by the displacement of solid boundary. Due to solid wall displacement, these are capable of providing quite large pressure ratios. These are further classified as reciprocating type and rotary type. Reciprocating type compressors generally employ piston cylinder arrangement, where displacement of piston in cylinder causes rise in pressure. Reciprocating compressors are capable of giving large pressure ratio, but the mass handling capacity is limited or small. Rotary compressors are capable of running at higher speed and can handle large mass flow rate than reciprocating compressors of positive displacement type. A dynamic or a non-positive displacement compressors are steady flow compressors where solid boundary for realizing pressure rise takes place. Here fluid is not contained in definite volume and subsequently volume reduction does not occur as in case of positive displacement compressors. Non-positive displacement compressors may be of axial flow type and centrifugal flow type depending on the type of flow in the compressor. Apart from this, compressors are classified based on number of stages as single stage where delivery pressure is up to 5 bar, 2 stage compressor delivery pressure between 5 to 35 bar, 3 stage compressor where delivery pressure is between 35 to 85 bar, and 4 stage compressor where delivery pressure is greater than 85 bar. We have one more classification which is based on capacity of compressor, that is low capacity compressor where air delivery capacity is around 0.15 meter cube per second or less, medium capacity compressor where capacity is between 0.15 to 5 meter cube per second, and high capacity compressor where air delivery capacity is more than 5 meter cube per second. We can also have one more classification that is based on highest pressure developed, that is low pressure compressor where maximum pressure is up to 1 bar, medium pressure compressor where pressure is between 1 bar to 8 bar, high pressure compressor where maximum pressure from 8 to 10 bar, and super high pressure compressor where maximum pressure is more than 10 bar. Now moving on to the next part, that is reciprocating compressors. Reciprocating compressors has piston cylinder arrangement as shown in the figure. You can see the piston cylinder arrangement with two stroke represented here. One is suction stroke, second one is compression and delivery stroke. Reciprocating compressors will generally have piston, cylinder, inlet, exit valves, connecting rod, crank, piston pin and crank pin, and a crankshaft. Inlet valve and exit valves may be of spring loaded type, which gets opened because of pressure differential across them. Let us consider the piston is at top dead center and move towards bottom dead center. Due to the movement of piston from TDC to BDC, suction pressure is created causing opening of the inlet valve. With this opening of inlet valve and suction pressure, the atmospheric air enters the cylinder, and the process is represented from 0.4 to 1 in the PV diagram. Air gets into cylinder during this stroke and subsequently compressed in the next stroke, which is represented from 0.1 to 0.2 on PV diagram, with both inlet and exit valve closed. Both inlet and exit valves are of plate type and spring loaded so as to operate automatically as and when sufficient pressure difference is available to cause deflection in spring of valve plate to open them. After piston reaches TDC, it reverses its motion, after reaches piston BDC, it reverses its motion and compresses the air inducted in previous stroke. Compression is continued till the pressure of air inside the cylinder becomes sufficient to cause deflection in the exit valve. At the moment of when exit valve plate gets lifted, the exhaust of compressed air takes place. This piston again reaches TDC, from where downward piston movement is again accompanied by suction. This is how a reciprocating compressor keeps on working as a flow device. In order to counter for heating of piston cylinder arrangement during compression, the provision of cooling is made in the form of cooling jackets in the body of the cylinder. Reciprocating compressor as described above as suction stroke from 0.4 to 1, compression stroke from 1 to 2, discharge from 2 to 3, and expansion as from 3 to 4. And the complete process is completed in 2 strokes of piston and 1 revolution of crankshaft. So we can have a thermodynamic analysis of this compression of air in compressor carried out here with three different types of thermodynamic processes, such as isothermal process, polytropic process or adiabatic process. Figure shows the thermodynamic cycles involved in compressor without clearance volume. Theoretical cycle is shown neglecting clearance volume, but in actual cycle clearance volume cannot be negligible. Clearance volume is necessary in order to prevent collision of piston with cylinder head and to accommodate valve mechanism, etc. Compression process is shown by process 1 to 2 as polytropic, 1 to 2 dash as isothermal, and 1 to 2 double dash as adiabatic in the figure. In PV diagram, the process 4 to 1 is followed by compression, that is 1 to 2, and discharge through the compressor is shown by the process 2 to 3. Air enters the compressor at pressure P1, here the pressure P1, and is compressed to pressure P2, here this is a pressure line P2. Compression work requirement can be estimated from the area below each compression curve. Area on PV diagram shows the work requirement shall be minimum with isothermal process 1 to 2 dash. That is, if you measure the area 1, 2 dash, 3 and 4, so the area is much lesser when compared to 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2 double dash, 3 and 4. So work requirement shall be minimum with respect to isothermal process. So, work requirement is maximum with adiabatic process. As a designer, one shall be interested in a compressor having minimum compression work requirement. Therefore, ideally compression should occur isothermally for minimum work input. But in practice, it is not possible to have isothermal compression because constancy of temperature during compression cannot be realized. Generally, compressors run at substantially high speed, while isothermal compression requires a compressor to run at very low speed so that heat evolved during compression is dissipated out and temperature remains constant. Actually, due to high speed running of compressor, the compression process may be assumed to nearer to adiabatic or polytropic processes, following the law of compression as PV to the power of n is equal to constant, where n value varies between 1.25 to 1.35 for air. Further moving, we will see expressions for work done per cycle. So, we have two cases, that is ideal single stage with clearance volume and without clearance volume. So, we will first see ideal stage with no clearance volume. So, for this case we have three categories. The first category is if the process of compression is polytropic, as we have discussed earlier. So, for this case we will make use of PV diagram and we will consider the process from 1 to 2 for polytropic process. So, work done per cycle is given by the area 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1. So, now we are going to split this into different processes. So, like 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4 and 4, 1. So, if you add up all these areas, you will get the total area of the PV diagram for work done per cycle. Now, the work 1 to 2 is, or the area 1 to 2 represents polytrophic. So, work is given by P2 V2 minus P1 V1 over N minus 1. So, the work or the area 2, 3 is given by P2 V2 as the process is constant pressure. So, it should be written as P1 V1 minus P2 V2, as P1 V1 is initial and P2 V2 is final. But here P2 V2 is final, initial, and P3 V3 is final. But the final state of condition is negligible in this case, as there is no clearance, volume is 0. So for that case, volume V3 becomes 0. So P3 V3 is 0, and finally we can write it as P2 V2. And similarly, we will write it for the process 4-1 as P1 V1, where P4 V4 is 0. And the area 3-4, which is a constant volume process, will be taken as 0. So now we are going to take LCM as n minus 1, and we are going to multiply with P2 V2 with n minus 1 and P1 V1 with n minus 1. After simplification, we will get n by n minus 1 into P2 V2 minus P1 V1. And here we will take P1 V1 as common in this expression, and we will get this one. And further, for a polytropic process, we can write the relation as P1 V1 n is equal to P2 V2 n, where writing in the form of volume ratio, that is V2 over V1 is equal to P1 over P2 whole to the power of 1 by n. By interchanging the numerator and denominator, we will get P2 over P1 whole to the power of minus 1 by n. Now we are going to replace V2 over V1 with this relation, so we will get this one. So after simplification, making simplification for the power of this pressure ratio, so we will get n minus 1 by n here. And then we have P1 V1 is equal to mRT1 from perfect gas equation. So we will replace P1 V1 with mRT1 as we have done here. And we also have the relation for temperature and pressure as T2 over T1 is equal to P2 over P1 whole to the power of n minus 1 over n. And now we are going to replace this term with T2 over T1, and taking the LCM here, we will get T2 minus T1 over T1, and T1 T1 get cancelled, and work expression becomes n by n minus 1 MR into T2 minus T1. And this is an expression which is used to find out the work of compression if it is a polytropic process with no clearance volume. So moving on to the second case, which is compression is reversible adiabatic means it is also called as isentropic process. So work done for cycle can be taken as area on PV diagram 1 2 3 4 1. So here, instead of taking 2 double dash, I have taken 2 to avoid confusions. So area 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 1 represents a reversible adiabatic process. You can see here, instead of 2 double dash, we have taken 2. So now we are going to write it as area 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and 3, 4 as well as 4, 1. 1 to 2 is adiabatic, so we will write it as P2 V2 minus P1 V1 over gamma minus 1. Then area 2, 3 is constant pressure, we will write it as P2 V2. And the second term will go off here because the volume is 0, V3. And then from 3, 4 it is constant volume 0. And here from 4 to 1, V4 is 0. So we will get P1 V1 minus P2, P4 V4. So and finally it gives P1 V1. So now we are going to take LCM here, and we are going to simplify the terms. We will get gamma by gamma minus 1 into P2 V2 minus P1 V1. In this expression, we will take P1 V1 as common, so we will get this expression. And we know for polytropic process or for adiabatic process, P1 V1 gamma is equal to P2 V2 gamma, where V2 over V1 is equal to P1 over P2 whole to the power of 1 by gamma, which is equal to P2 over P1 whole to the power of minus 1 by gamma. Now we are going to replace V2 over V1 in this expression with this relation, and simplifying the powers, we will get this expression, that is gamma by gamma minus 1 into P1 V1 into P2 over P1 whole to the power of gamma by gamma minus 1 minus 1. Since we know that P1 is equal to mRT1, we are going to replace P1 with mRT1. And we have the relation for temperature, T2 over T1 is equal to P2 over P1 whole to the power of gamma by gamma minus 1. So now we are going to replace this term with T2 over T1, and taking LCM, we will get T2 minus T1 by T1, and T1 T1 get cancelled, and the expression becomes gamma by gamma minus 1 into MR into T2 minus T1. So further, here we have the relation for gas constant R is equal to Cp minus Cv. So here Cp is taken common, so it becomes Cp into 1 minus Cv over Cp, and we know that gamma is equal to Cp over Cv. So here Cv over Cp can be written as 1 by gamma, and we are going to simplify this as we get Cp into gamma minus 1 over gamma, and we will write this expression in the form of Cp. So Cp is equal to R into gamma over gamma minus 1. So here R into gamma over gamma minus 1 can be written as Cp, and therefore work equation becomes mCp into T2 minus T1, and this is an expression used to determine work of compression if the process is reversible adiabatic with no clearance volume. So moving on to next one, which is case 3, if the process of compression is isothermal process. So work done on the cycle is given by area under 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1. To avoid confusion, instead of taking 2 dash, we have taken 2. So now area is splitted as area 1 to 2 dash, 2, 3, 3, 4 and 4, 1. Simultaneously, we will write the expressions here. So it is isothermal process from 1 to 2 dash. So P1 V1 ln V1 by V2 is the work expression. Then plus P2 V2 for constant pressure. Then 0 for constant volume from 3 to 4. And for 4 to 1, which is constant pressure, written as P1 V1. Since P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 because the process is isothermal, so we can replace either P2 V2 or P1 V1 with this relation, and the terms will go off, and finally we left with P1 V1 ln V1 over V2. Since we know P1 V1 is equal to MRT1 and V1 over V2 can be written as P2 over P1. So we will replace P1 V1 with MRT1 and V1 over V2 with P2 over P1 from this relation. So moving on to next one. So the second category, that is ideal stage when we consider clearance volume. So taking the process as polytropic process. So we are going to find out work done per cycle. So here area 1, 2, 5, 6 and 1 represents the area of polytropic process without clearance, and the area 4, 3, 5, 6 and 1, which is also a polytropic process, and this area is taken. So if you take the difference between the area 1, 2, 5, 6 and 1 with area 4, 3, 5, 6 and 1, we will get the net work done which is required here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 as a work done per cycle with clearance. So now we will see what is the expression for area 1, 2, 5, 6, 1 and area 4, 3, 5, 6, 4 individually. Now we will take first area 1, 2, 5, 6, 1. So we are going to split this as area 1, 2, 2, 5, 5, 6 and 6, 1. And we will write the expressions P2 V2 minus P1 V1 over N minus 1 plus P2 V2 minus 0 minus P1 V1. And simplifying this equation, we will get N by N minus 1 into P2 V2 minus P1 V1, and which can be written as N by N minus 1 by taking P1 V1 as common. And we know the process polytropic as V2 over V1 is equal to P1 over P2 whole to the power of 1 by N. By interchanging the pressure terms, we will get negative sign here, and we are going to replace V2 over V1 with this relation, and simplifying for the power, we will get this expression. Okay, and this expression is used for area 1, 2, 5, 6, 1, and it is named as equation 2. And now we will go for area, the second area 4, 3, 5, 6, 4. So, and it is separated as 4, 3, 5, 4, 3, 3, 5, 6, 5, 6 and 6, 4. And we are going to write the expression as P3, V3, P4, V4 over N minus 1 plus P3, V3 minus 0 minus P4, V4. And we are going to take, or we are going to simplify the expression, and we will get N by N minus 1 P3 V3 minus P4 V4, and P4 V4 is taken as common here, and we will get this expression, and we have the relation here for polytropic process, that is V3 over V4 is equal to P4 over P3 whole to the power of N 1 by N. By interchanging the pressure term, we will get negative sign here, and We are going to replace V3 or V4 from previous expression as this, and we are going to simplify for the power term. As we do that, we will get n by n minus 1 into P4 V4 into P3 over P4 whole to the power of n minus 1 by n minus 1, and it is equation number 3. Now we are going to substitute equation 1 in equation 1 with equation 2 and 3. We will get this, and in this case, so we know that P2 or P1 and P3 or P4 are same by seeing your PV diagram. You can replace P2 with P3 as P2 is equal to P3 and as P1 with P4 as in your PV diagram. So the term remains same. You can take as common from these two terms, and n by n minus 1 is also common. So and the expression becomes n by n minus 1 into P1 V1 minus P4 V4 multiplied with P2 over P1 whole to the power of n minus 1 by n minus 1, since P1 is equal to P4 as well as P3 is equal to P2. Further, so the expression can be written as n by n minus 1 and P1 is equal to P4. So either you can take P1 or P4 as common. What you have done here is that, and P1 is multiplied with V1 minus V4 multiplied with P2 over P1 n minus 1 over n minus 1, and it is equation number 4. Further moving this, so we have from PV diagram, so this is a PV diagram with clearance. So V1 minus V4 is represented as WhatsApp volume Vs. So this is V4 and this is V1. So V4 represents for the process of this, when the process is 4, 3, 5, 6, 4, the clearance volume is V4. If the process is 1, 2, 5, 6 and 1, 2, 3, 4, the clearance volume will be taken as V3. So based on that, we will consider only the process 4 and 1. So during this process, the clearance volume is V4, the total volume is V1. So if you take the difference between the total volume and the clearance volume, we will get the self volume, that is from 0.4 to 0.1. So now we are going to replace V1 minus V4 from previous expression with Vs. As we know from perfect gasification, PV is equal to MRT. So we are going to replace P1 V1 is MRT1. Then further, we can make some conclusions on the above expression, that clearance volume has no effect on the work done of air delivered, but clearance volume reduces the quantity of air compressed or capacity of the compressor. For single acting compressors running with n RPM, power input requirement, assuming clearance volume from equation 4, that is from the previous slide. So you can write it as n by n minus 1 P1 into V1 minus V4 multiplied with P2 over P1 into n minus 1 over n minus 1. And it is single acting, so you will multiply with a speed of the compressor. And if it is a double acting, we will multiply speed with 2 times, as that it is a double acting compressor. So speed will be doubled. And these are the two expressions which are used to find out the power. When work done is multiplied with speed, you will get power for single acting as well as double acting. And this ends the session on introduction as well as single acting compressor. Thank you so much. Please do subscribe to my channel, BR Mech Academy.